Hi, welcome to this new tutorial. In the past, we talked about Spring Boot with JDBC, and today we are going to see how we can connect to MySQL using this time the Java Persistent API. And in this tutorial, I assume that you are familiar with the basic JPA knowledge. And then regarding the script code used in this tutorial, I will put the link available in the description under this video, my YouTube channel. So let's get started. So today we are going to talk about JPA, and then what is the basic overview? The basic overview is this one. We are let me explain what we are going to do. So as what this the basic overview we have here, we'll have one database here. This is our database, and here we are going to write the application properties. We are going to set the application properties of this database, and this database is having one table. Its name Spring Boot, and is having one table called students. And then after that, we are going to create one entity class called student that will communicate with the database. So we start with the database with configuration here, then we go to our entity class under our model. And then after we declare our entity class, now we are going to create the repository here, interface here, that which will implement the CRUD repository. And then after it's created, we are going to have here, it's going to forward this one here to our controller class. And in this controller class, you are going to implement the basic REST methods that will be called using different URL. And then here after this one, we have our main class that is going to be executed. So in that set, we are basically we are going to focus on this three one here in this tutorial, and assume that you have already created the database. So that is the general overview of this tutorial. And then in order to do that, let us go to SES and then start it. So we go to new project, Spring Starter project, and here we enter the name of our project and make sure that the Java version corresponds to the current one that you have installed in your computer. Then next here we have here, we'll go to SQL here and select our dependency. Here we select JPA, and then the database is MySQL. And then after that, we go to the web and select web. So we have our three packages that are here selected, then finish. So when our project is being created here, I will go here and show the database. This is a database here. Our database here is having one table, and the table is having the student ID, the name, and the program. So this is the basic structure of our table that we are going to deal with. And you can see from the structure here, yeah, that the type of the student ID is integer, and then the two other are varchar, meaning strings. So that into accounts. And currently here this one is a primary key, but it's not auto generated. And now we go, suppose expecting that our project is created here. Yeah, so now we are going to create our entity class here under the model. we create student. So here is our student class here, which implement is our student class here that will have three properties: integer, student ID, and string name. String program here, and so here is our basic stuff here. And because the entity class, we are going to call the entity tag here. Import entity. So here is our basic entity class, and now we are going to create so just to make, in order to make the tutorial short here, I've prepared a sample class here. If you just take the sample class here, and explain it later. If we save it here, so what we have done is to create the entity student as the entity class here. Here we call the entity tag and specify the table name here, student. Table name, that this entity is attached to this table here, and then set the student ID as the primary key. Here is the student ID, and then we add the column. This one corresponds to the column name in the table, and as well as the program. Then we call the empty constructor, and then initialize this constructor, non-empty constructor, and then to string later on when we need to find and to list stuffs in the browser. So that's it. This is our entity class, which is ready. Now, so the next thing here, as you have seen in this tutorial here, will be to create we have created this one. Now we go and create our repository. So we go again here and create our interface here under repository. Student repository. Here is our student repository here, and if you just take this one here, you can see that we are just implementing, we are just extending the CRUD interface. So we extend this CRUD interface here. Here is our student repository, that is okay. And when we do this one, we are going to implement all methods that are within this CRUD interface. And here we specify the student ID, and then the integer here refers to the type of our primary key. So the last thing to be created now is our controller. So we go here and create a new class and name it student controller, and here we put the package under controller. So here is our controller class here. Before we go and explain it, let's save it. So here is our controller here. We add rest here to convert it into a controller. I created our controller here, then add the stack rest controller. Now it becomes a controller, and then we inject the repository so that we can call it. Now we try to find all here to be thrown to the body as will be converted as a JSON. Here we try to find all from the repository class. Here you can see repository is having different method that we can use. So that's it. And then here, find all, we are going to find all directly and convert each entity to a string so that we can return everything as a block of string. Then we are going to find by ID, and by finding by ID here, this is a dynamic URL here that we are using and to be passed to find one here, and then it will return our student. Then the last one is to create a new student that is registering a students. And here we try to just, instead of create having a dynamic UI here, we just initialize it directly using our normal constructor. And here we pass the ID to 11 we are in. Tutorial, JPA tutorial. So that is it here. So the last thing to do now is to go here to our application properties here, to go to the application properties and try to put a credential to our database here. And then we are just going to add it here, and this one refer to the link to our MySQL. Here we can see it is running under this port 3306 here. So that is the port of MySQL, and then this is the name of the database, and Spring Boot here is the username and the password. And here, be careful, here we set Spring JPA generate DGL to true. So I think DGL is the data definition language, we set it to true. Yeah, so that is it here. Our application is ready. We can now just go and hopefully check here our Apache is working, our database is running. So let's go and see what we currently have here. Last ID here is 10, and then you have JPA, JPA tweet. So here you expect to have something running. So if you just click on these applications here and then go to run, as Spring Boot. Application. So here I started here. So hopefully we go to our browser, localhost here, find all. Bam! Yeah, so here you are having all the properties that have been returned here. And then if you write here find register student registered here, and this is the message that is returned from our own controller when we register a student here. If the student, we are now, we can expect to see this one in the database. So if you go to our database and refresh it again, pump, so we are in JPA tutorial. And then the last one is if you want to find by ID. So in order to find by ID, find by student student ID here, bam, so our student ID is coming. If we change it to student. Here we have student is coming. So here this ID is 11 here. So we pass this ID to 11, and here you can see that this student with the ID 11 is coming. So you have to be careful here. We specify here this name, find student ID, and then you have this is interrogation points, then student ID, which is the attribute that we want, and then we pass equal and we pass the ID. So that is it, and I hope that at least this tutorial has been helpful to you. So this is just a basic tutorial, and I just want to show some steps that you can do, or you can proceed to do that one. And then if do not worry about the source code, I will put it available on the in my blog. I will put it there so that you can just take it from there and then run it. So I hope that you like it, and then stay tuned for the next video tutorial. Ciao.